Bridget here with the one and only Cathy Rigby.
Hi, Bridget.
And we're here with our pet iguana, the Chiller. And I just wanted to ask you a few questions about your gymnastics career.
Okay.
Can we talk a little bit about that? Me being a dancer for the past 20 years, you were obviously one of my influences. Can we just talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. I did gymnastics. I started when I was 10 years old, and I made my first Olympics in 68 when I was 15, and then I went to my second Olympics in Munich, and I guess one of the pioneers of gymnastics. I was very fortunate to be one of the first women to win a medal, American women to win a medal in world competition. So it was a time when we were pioneering the sport, but I absolutely loved it.
And what did that feel like to be like in that moment, like of time, and just?
You know what it's like? It's like my, you know, Broadway or anything. You know, you have one chance every 4 years to make an Olympic team. He's gonna crawl on my head. Anyway, you have one chance every 4 years, so you, like, as you know, you work your whole life for something, and you hope it all works on that day. And but it certainly teaches you a lot about pursuing any goal.
Do you want to just talk about some of your favorite, like, gymnastics moves when you're still competing, or?
Well, I think when I did gymnastics, probably the most difficult things were aerial walkovers and double twists on the floor and on the balance beam aerials and back handsprings. And so, though, you know, we work 6 to 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, for the most part, training. And and now it's a little, you know, it's a little more scientific, I think, and the fact that they have floor exercise mats that have, you know, this much spring under them, it's wonderful, because now they can do moves that are even more difficult. And so, you know, that aspect of it, I wish I could have done it back then too. It was great fun.
How has gymnastics, like, changed since then? How is the dance world completely different?
Well, I have to tell you that I run the McCoy Rigby Conservatory of the Arts, so we do dance, we do competitive dance, and we do other things, but one of the things, and I have to tell you, there's an awful lot of tricks in dance these days, which I think comes from a lot of the gymnastics and acrobatics. And what I love about that with the dancers is that one of the things that I think we've lost in gymnastics is the artistic side, and what we see in the dance is now a little bit of gymnastics with the dance, and I love that, because that's my sport, that's where I came from. And to see these kids so effortlessly jumping and spinning, and along with the ballet, it reminds me of rhythmic gymnastics, and it's something I love.
So another thing I wanted to talk about was your role in Peter Pan. I actually relate to you a lot, being a dancer. I also was Seymour in Little Shop of Horrors one time, so I played a male role too. Can you talk a little bit about that?
These androgynous roles. You know what, it's really fun. Probably the greatest compliment is when I'm on stage and I come off stage, and a little boy, it's a little boy, will come up and goes, "Were you Peter Pan?" And when they see you up close, it's different than on stage. He goes, "I thought you were a boy." And I go, "Well, I am a boy," and they'll argue with me, and it's very funny. But there's a whole technique that is so different in acting than playing a child, and especially a boy, that you can't fake out the kids. They know, you know. So hopefully on stage you can look enough like a boy, and you can work, you know, they're kind of effortless in their movement and in their mannerisms, and it feels really great when you can do that and they believe you're a boy.
All right, this was Cathy Rigby. Thank you for watching.